Many would term Atmosphere Hotels and Resorts' entry into the Indian market in current challenging times as a foolhardy decision. However, it can also be viewed as an opportunistic move. Having suffered significant losses since 2020, several hotel owners are willing to renegotiate terms with boutique brands rather than hospitality chains. The company's founder, Salil Panigrahi, and its newly appointed MD for India, Sri Lanka, Nepal and Bhutan, Sauvagya Mohapatra, tell us how Atmosphere Hotels and Resorts is well poised to tap the growing demand for destination travel in South Asia.
So the family vacations will be an interesting thing to watch, because the holidays are quite a bit of family vacations in India. People will be worried till the children are vaccinated to go out, because they will be worried. And being a mainland, and there is a chance of more contact, I would say that family holiday will take little more time to pick up, whether it is India or the mainland. What we are seeing that in Maldives, the smaller island, the parents are more confident. It's a small island, contact with the bigger world is less. So you might find, you know, Maldives, Seychelles, Fiji, you know, those island nations might pick up faster for family holidays.
The hospitality sector has seen both subtle and substantial shifts since the pandemic struck. Many hotel properties were shelved, postponed, or put on hold temporarily. Has this global disruption affected Atmosphere's growth plan, or is it still on track to achieve its goals, which it had planned in 2019 or the beginning of 2020?
Well, definitely it has been detracted. I would say that the growth has been hampered, but innovative ways to counter it and see new things. You know, I felt this is an opportunity also to look at India. India was on our back burner. Maybe we would have done that in 2022 or 23. So in the meantime, we found there is a gap and that we have got time in the hand. Rather use the time for something else. In Maldives, some of our projects are on hold, some on progress. Sri Lanka on hold because of the border closing, and sometimes there are opportunities with the situation. Mr. Sauvagya managed to join us, and we saw that there could be an opportunity to look at India. We have got two more projects in Maldives. One was supposed to open on 2021. Work is going on, but it's in a slower pace. It was supposed to open on March, now it will open on December. So other projects which were supposed to start this year, they have been pushed to 2022. Sri Lanka, we were supposed to start 2021 because our planning design was completed. I think it will move to 2022. India is a new venture. India, we are venturing new. So we have to see how it progresses, what interest we get. I believe it will take us a couple of months or a year to do some groundbreaking.
Given that it has a well-outlined roadmap for the Indian subcontinent, will Atmosphere Hotels and Resorts become a mass operator or prefer to remain a boutique entity with select number of properties?
Initially, we'll definitely go for the destinations, you know, at least the best of the properties. The past properties of 10 properties or 7 properties or 5 properties will definitely give a recognition in India. We don't want to go for mass immediately, but definitely the time will establish, will go one by one. Yes, if you're getting a chain group of hotels and it's a luxury brands, we'll definitely go for it. That is one. Number two, as you said, there'll be after this pandemic, definitely lot of owners, they will try to renegotiate the companies, and that is a big opportunity for us to be in the part and to give our brand value a bit different image. And already Mr. Salil has done the lot of homework for me. He has already put a band in such a positions. It will become very easy for at least give a backup. Yes, it is there. People want to see. Then that is the proof. They were the kind of service, the kind of hospitality, the kind of hotel projects, the kind of facility. He has created a lot of things. Now I have to carry it in India. That is one.
As Atmosphere also considers opening properties in cities, how will it take the DNA of its destination-driven brands and amalgamate them into a city hotel?
We'll definitely try, you know, to tier 2 city will be the first criteria. If we'll get a good tier 2 city, we'll definitely go for the better destination properties next to the city hotels. And, you know, another point I've forgotten to mention, you know, the biggest market for the next after 1 or 2 years definitely will be MICE. And, you know, even if also MICE is going to play a bigger role, and we'll definitely catch, if it's next to the city hotel, we can definitely try for that with a good banqueting. Let's, if it is a Hyderabad, we'll definitely try for a, if it is a city hotel, we'll try for MICE, not only for the destinations.
You ask a question about a DNA. It is paramount for any brand to be built, to build their own DNA, and where they will be characterized by certain elements, because in the hoteliering, in the hospitality, majority of the things are driven with certain convictions and certain concepts. But what's your DNA is a, that's how it makes a difference. And that's where Marriott, you brought the issue of Marriott, Accor, I would say, they have a DNA, it's called guest comfort and assurance.
Atmosphere prides itself on building urban sanctuaries, not just hotels. With its varied sub-brands, it will need to customize these to the location and local customer preferences. Without diluting its brand characteristics, won't that be a tough balance?
So you must appreciate we both are from a neutral place. Me and Mr. Salil, we are not any big cities. We are from the Odisha and we have a character of neutrality. And second, we'll definitely, as a human resource is concerned, we'll definitely honor the local more and definitely will give importance as the, we'll go by the land of law of the land, whatever the minimum numbers we have to keep, we will keep, and definitely we'll add some professionals from outside. That is one. Number two, maintaining, I was maintaining almost 12 hotels in almost 6 states. So here you have to maintain at least, you know, maybe 10 states or 12 states, maybe 20, 25 hotels. So it's not a big job. And second, maybe in Sri Lanka, Nepal or Bhutan, the people characters are almost similar. Whether it's a man force or the customers or the guest or the people who are coming to enjoy, the almost the characters almost maximum 70-80% is similar. So it has become very easy to maintain. And they all require, say, care. Whether it's a well, who is paying to you or to whom you are paying. Both the guests require care. And we'll definitely, and Mr. Salil also is a master in that, to take care of his employee or the guest. Pampering is a very, your word, you know, makes people different. You know, people, if you're getting a lapse in the both guest and the room guest, sorry, outside guest or inside guest, then your things are done. We'll okay. Take care of that.
If there is one thing that the pandemic has made businesses realize, it is a need to empower their people and give them some level of autonomy. How does Atmosphere plan to do this, enabling not just the general managers, but other customer-facing employees as well?
As already Mr. Salil, what I marked in the Atmosphere, he has created a beautiful hierarchy. And that hierarchy will continue here. And everybody will take the responsibility and they will take care of it. And you know, in India, I think we will definitely get best people. And also we will get the better people from the, some of the better people from the Maldives hotel or from the Maldives operations or the other part of the operations. Then we'll mix up the culture. Automatically they'll learn the culture of Atmosphere. We'll definitely go more on the casual approach, like the people, you know, the guest must feel comfortable, staff also feel most comfortable. And the time you'll do that, you know, the ownership will develop automatically. Yes, it is my hotel. You know, the time we will take care of the staffs, automatically they will take care of your guests. I think Atmosphere mantra will be that only.
I will add, I will be a little philosophical on it. The whole thing about my take on guest satisfaction is managing the guest expectations. We are dealing with human beings, not with robot. That's why I say that this is one industry which connects human to human. So I call it as a humanitarian industry. I believe the core philosophy of ours, besides joy of giving, is humanity. You cannot have hospitality without humanity. You cannot employ robots to give service to the guests. So managing the guest expectations are very important. And when we do the managing the guest expectations, I call next thing smart service, because the population in the world has got a set of behavior. As you know the set of behavior, if you tailor-made things for them, the service becomes very easy.